Yo, what's going on, guys? Boy, Ooze back in once again with another manga reaction. And just a little quick update for y'all. If you're wondering what happened to the Boruto reaction, I think it was, that got removed. And I don't know why considering, I should say, that we've been doing these manga reactions for quite some time now. But so going forward, I'm just going to take another precaution and just make sure that since I do show partial, images to the official manga right off of the Shonen Jump website, then I'm just going to go ahead and add some filtering and, you know, the cropping is still going to be there. So I'm still staying true to what I was told I was allowed to do. And that way, I don't put my channel at any further risk. But yeah, obviously this is of course to kind of highlight my reaction to the chapter, to review it as I read it, give you guys my thoughts. It's not to basically give you guys a free way into reading the official manga chapters, which obviously you can go and support it on your own, which I always encourage, and you know, I always highly encourage to support the official releases anyway. So with all that out of the way and being said, let's get right in. All right, so this one's gonna be a crazy chapter because if you remember, my man Lemillion Mirio is back again once again. Just like I said, we're gonna start things off looking at Mary. I know she had a role in this, and I hope to God that we get a backstory as to how she was able to repair him. So we'll see right now. So this is chapter 293, Hero Saturated Society. Deku says, "You're here, Lemillion? But how?" "We got word from the villa about what's happening, so I rushed over using my special permeation mode of travel. You see, the villain hideout that the Night Eye Agency is keeping tabs on isn't far from here. I've only been on sabbatical for half a year, not long enough to trigger any nostalgia just yet. Bubble Girl was nice enough to tell me about the multi-pronged battle plan going down tomorrow, and I want to help out. I know you've been practicing on bugs and lizards these past 2 months using small amounts of energy. I've seen the progress you're making. So please, Eri, I'm sorry for using you like this, but won't you try out your rewind power on me? And then, don't be sorry. This is why I'm training. Thank you." Yeah, I knew it. I knew Eri was the one, man. Eri had to be the one. So she'd been practicing on bugs and lizards. That's actually pretty fire. And the fact that she was able to rewind him, I mean, it's believable because why wouldn't it be believable? She was able to rewind Deku literally live on, like, in the heat of battle and in the midst of all the action, all right? "Still, even my power ain't enough to take down these gnomes with one punch, so..." Anyone. "The explosions that from that time were like nothing I'd ever done. All condensed, faster, stronger, too. I've never felt that sensation like being on death's door in total crisis." Holy crap, that's Bakugo. "Gotta save." What the hell? Yo, what's going on? "Bakugo, I can't take my eyes off of you for even a second. You mustn't push yourself. It could be fatal." Dude, he's like going all out right now. "Nejide, you okay? Feeling just peachy now that you're here, Togata. Weird, huh? Well, have you experienced the world, Bakugo?" "That name was temporary. I held off on the big reveal until you could hear it. Your alias represents your desires, but you are still naive to the ways of the world." Oh yeah, that's right. Best Genius was his teacher. I remember that. "Once you've earned your provisional license in your second year, return to me, and on that day, tell me your chosen name. Starting today, I'm Great Explosion Murder God Dynamite." That is such a perfect name. "How childish. What a mouthful. Disturbing. Tacky. Super tacky. Ha ha. A fine hero name with a real sense of humor to it. Ain't nothing funny about it. A world without smiles and humor has no bright future. No offense intended, buddy. That's just my motto. Anywho, looks like their boss is going nowhere fast. So what do you say we wrap this up? Dude, this chapter is ridiculous. This art is amazing. Oh, your friends are having a blast down there. Oh, here, I think this is Dobby. Yup, poor Shoto. No fun for you, just pain. But you're burning up too. Seriously, it's great that you were raised with love. I'm fine because I'm really happy right now. Because look at that face. The guy's about to watch his puppet masterpiece burn up and die in the fire of his failed experiment. And he can't do anything. I said, look, he's totally broken inside. Oh my god. He's literally like burning himself in Todoroki. Shoto, obviously. Once my fire burns you to ash, I wonder what kind of face dad'll make. Oh, what's going on? Did he hit him back? Oh, no. The Black Whip. Okay, that's Black Whip. That's Deku. The others are backing up Genus, so I've got you, Todoroki. Who cares if my arms and legs are done? Froppy style. Oh, he did the Black Whip out of his mouth. Damn, that's crazy. This is a family affair. None of your business. It is my business, because Todoroki's my friend, and Endeavor's my mentor who's made me stronger. Sure, the past never dies, and that's why I'm watching Endeavor real hard as he tries to be better. And guess what? You aren't Endeavor. What? Oh, Midoriya. Ha ha ha, way to state the obvious, but still, you gotta pity me, right? That agent of justice did some vile stuff, and I'm the result. Evil is thriving. Justice is losing this war. All I'm doing is showing you sentimental dopes. Who's to blame for that? The future coming down the pipeline, the feeling, just like earlier, is one where all that schmaltz and lip service is going to get blown away by the chaos. Yikes. Uh-oh, he's back up. Oh, yeah, he broke out the jeans. Power. Suddenly all gone. Makia, no strength. That reminds me, the message I got from the gang at the villa. They say their strategy had no effect, but look, indeed, someone out there weaved this thread of hope. This sedative must have worked. All right, we in there. We are in there. All right, so I gotta say, man, this chapter was fire, like always. This arc is ridiculous. Like, you guys actually have no idea, like, how crazy this is. Because, like I said last week when I did the catch-up episode, there has been so much that has gone on during this arc. And I honestly cannot believe how amazing it has been. And it's still going on. And I feel like it's kind of almost getting towards some form of a climax, but the way things have been going, it's almost as if like any kind of surprises might just, you know, come out of nowhere, just like how Mirio came in last minute to help them out, to give them that extra pair of hands in, you know, in this whole entire situation. And hopefully, I'm hoping that it kind of does tie up, because dude, I don't know. Like, if they try to throw in anything else at us, like, I feel like people are just going to lose their freaking minds at that point. But, like, honestly, like I said, great chapter. This arc is amazing. I, you know, really don't have anything much else to say without repeating myself already. I really love how the explanation behind Muriel's return was as simple as I had predicted it. And I'm sure a lot of you guys shared the same sentiment and the same predictions, and that Eri had everything to do with how he was able to return. They didn't waste too much time on that. The backstory was very concise and straight to the point. And my man, just like that, was able to, boom, come right back into action. Like, he didn't miss a beat. He came back with the freaking power full on. So, again, I'm really happy about that as well. And I'm hoping to see exactly what kind of happened. I mean, now that Mach is out of the picture, because the sedative seemed to have worked, let's also not forget that there's still apparently a traitor amongst the heroes. We don't know who that is just yet, but it is a thing, and it's something to keep in mind and to like keep in the back of your head, because all this craziness has happened, so it's easy to forget little things like that. But remember they did have a hunch earlier on in this arc that there was a traitor. So we'll have to wait and see, as always. And we might, that actually might be the one little plot twist that right when we think that the heroes are going to come out of this, where Dobby literally almost burnt Todoroki to a crisp and Endeavor was looking all sad or whatever, and like, and Makiha looked like it was a, they were about to like trample on everything. Watch whoever this traitor is come out and like totally turn the tides, or like make it even or something. I don't know. And literally anything can happen. I'm looking forward to seeing it. Let me know your thoughts. What do you think is going to happen in the next few chapters or so? Take care of yourselves. May the power protect you. Keep it locked loaded right here on this channel. Make sure you guys are looking at my description so that you can continue to support this channel outside of liking and subscribing and sharing. And of course, hit that damn bell so that way y'all get notified exactly when all of my uploads go live. Please take care of yourselves. May the power protect you. Keep it locked loaded right here. Like I said, can't stress that enough. Stay inside. Take it easy. May the power protect you. Keep it locked loaded. And I will see y'all.